In this video, I'm going to show you how I replaced drum brakes with disc brakes.
We're going to remove the lockout hubs on this 68 Bronco. And there you go, just like that.
Here we've removed the lockout hub on the driver's side.
We've removed this retaining clip. Now we're going to remove this retaining screw right here. We're going to remove this retaining clip from around the outside of the hub. It's going to allow this piece to come out right here. It's a little tricky. I've got a hooked tool. Just trying to drag it out of there. There we go. So I've removed this retaining clip right here, and then this axle retaining clip is going to come off as well. So I work this thing loose. Okay, I'm going to use this spindle nut remover. It's going to fit right in here on the spindle nut. It doesn't take a lot of pressure to start taking that spindle nut out.
And then this last retaining clip, you just got to kind of get behind it and pull it out.
What'd you call that?
Swap
ends?
Yeah.
There
we
go.
With all the nuts removed, the drum comes right off.
I've removed the nut on the brake line right there. Now I'm going to proceed to remove these six bolts. So we're going to grind off this little piece of metal right here. So this is this new spindle from Tom's Bronco Parts. It's got this seal right here that just stays right down in there. Then it has the thrust washer, and the beveled edge goes towards the knuckle. So in this case, you're going to be looking at the beveled edge. It's going to be roughly centered. And now this spindle seal is going to pound into place on top of that. I did that with a rubber mallet. Trying to keep that thrust washer somewhat in place. You can move it a little bit afterwards. Now you can see that this is going in nicely. It's going flush. I'm trying to be somewhat gentle with it, moving that thrust washer back into place. There we go. So now I'm going to put the spindle on this axle shaft. I'll line that up with the bolt holes, but then the backing plate goes on top of this and the whole thing bolts together right there. Now these bolts are going to torque to 35 to 45 foot-pounds, and I set the torque wrench at 40. So I've packed the bearing with grease, and now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to let this sit down in here like that. I dry fit it to make sure that was the right one. So now we're going to pound this seal. Once we have the wheel bearing in there, we're going to pound this seal into it. Okay, now I'm just making sure that this is fully seated and it's flush all the way around. I'm going to grease this lip right here. So this is an example of what it looks like without the hub and rotor assembly. Because it's really hard to see, I'm going to put it together, or at least demonstrate how it gets put together without that on there. Now what you do is you put the bearing on, and then this nut actually holds that bearing on. You torque this to 50 foot-pounds, and then you put on this locking ring right here. It has to go into this groove right here. It can only fit one way. Notice once I get it in there, it won't rotate. So then I get it to a nearby pin, like right there. If this is 50 foot-pounds, I get it lined up right there. But as I'm torquing this nut, I want to kind of rotate the hub back and forth a little bit just so the bearings won't get all messed up in there. I want them to torque nice and evenly and seat those bearings. So once I have this lock nut and the washer in place, you see the pin is seated. This is going to go on over the top of it. It's the outer. And I'm going to use the spindle nut. I'm going to use the spindle nut socket, and I'm going to torque this to 80 foot-pounds. Remember, this is all within the hub. Hub goes on. And goes on. Retaining nut with pin. I'm going to torque this to 50 pounds while we rotate the wheel, just to make sure those bearings. There we go. You can kind of feel the bearings slip a little bit in there as they're seating. Now that the bearings are preloaded, I'm going to back it off 90 degrees. So I'm just going to simply turn that nut back there until the pin goes through the hole on that retaining washer. Now that thing's seated, and this will go in. I'm going to torque this to 70 foot-pounds. It calls for 50 to 80, and I'm going to go for 70. Okay, we've got new worn hubs right here. Part number 20990. Here's the cap and here's the body, along with the miscellaneous parts. I take the body assembly. I've disconnected that from the cap. Body assembly is going to go into the hub. I'm going to take the lock ring. Install that. So it clicks into place. Now to check if this is seated correctly, I'm going to put a couple of the screws in there right now. There is some float evident. So it's installed properly. Take the cap, turn it to free. Gets pushed on. Now these screws go in. That's a hex head, and they get torqued to 45 to 55 inch-pounds.
The caliper and brake pads mount to the backing plate with two bolts, one on the top, one on the bottom. They run through from the backside, and then using the new flexible brake hose, you attach it to the brake system. Since this isn't stainless steel, it rusts really quickly. So I decided to paint the hub with automotive paint. I primered it and then hit it with some automotive paint. It looks really good, and you can see way better than the rust. The rust on the rotor is pretty normal, and it's covered up by the wheel anyway.
I've unbolted the master cylinder, and then that will just be removed.
This is the old H block right here. I've removed the brake lines and the bolt that holds it. This whole contraption used to run up to the old master cylinder, and now this entire thing is coming out. It's going to be replaced by the new proportioning valve. I'm just going to go in right about there. You can see the mounting bolt, and then there's a little guide hole right there that it will sit down into, and I'm going to put this retaining clip for the fuel line on top in case I ever need to get to that later. I don't have to take the entire proportioning valve out. We're going to bench bleed this by adding these lines right here. We're going to allow the fluid to come out from where the piston is, flow back up into the reservoir as I pump the brake. That'll blow any bubbles out of there, and if it sucks anything back in, it'll be just pure fluid. So I'll go ahead and push on the brake a little, and you will see bubbles, hopefully. We got in the kit this sensor. This is going to plug into the proportioning valve right down here, and the instructions call for these two wires to be cut and spliced onto this. So that's what we're going to do with this kit. We're attaching the sensor to the proportioning valve. We've spliced on the existing wiring right here, and I'm just going to zip tie this out of the way so it doesn't get hung up on anything or touch the manifold or anything like that. The master cylinder is now hooked up to the proportioning valve, and we're ready to bleed brakes. Hey, thanks for watching. Hopefully I helped some of you out, and be sure to subscribe.